We face what might be the challenge of this decade: to rethink and revitalize education at a time when the life we are preparing students for is changing as fast as our budgets are shrinking. As educational leaders feel this burden of doing more with less, many leaders draw on their own knowledge and insights. They want an innovative school, so they share their ideas. But more often than not, their well-thought-out plans fall flat with staff and faculty. People learn it's easier and safer to let the boss do the thinking. These leaders become diminishers of intelligence. We also found that most diminishing is done with the best of intentions. On the other end of the spectrum are leaders who use their intelligence to amplify the capabilities of the people around them. When these leaders walk into a room, light bulbs go on, ideas flow, and problems get solved. People get smarter and surpass expectations because they're given space, permission to think, and are challenged to do their best work. These leaders are multipliers. Compared to diminishers, these multipliers receive 2.3 times the levels of capability, essentially doubling their available brain force for free. This is the multiplier effect. Let's recognize that at the top of the intelligence hierarchy isn't the genius, but rather the genius maker. What could you or your school accomplish if you could mobilize all the energy and intelligence around you? We can't afford schools that operate on a fraction of the intelligence inside them. Unleash intelligence. Put it to work. See the multiplier effect.